Ciao comrades e nulla compañeros, welcome, pleasure to have you here. Today is a big day because YouTube on the PS Vita is back. This is it, I'm just watching a video on YouTube and it works pretty good as you can see. We can watch videos, we can watch live streams, we can watch videos in the background, we can download videos and we can download audio, but I'm not gonna be showing you those, those are against YouTube policies. And all of the videos are without ads. And today we are looking at how to install it on your Vita and pretty much all you need to know. So let's get into it. First and foremost, big up to the Graphene, the developer who came up with this update for the Netstream application. That's the one that we're gonna be using for watching YouTube. Previous release was June 2023 and this right here, version 3.3, is the latest one from yesterday. And there is even one more with some fixed bugs. So first, how to install the application on your PS Vita. Step 1, download the VPK from the GitHub official release page, link is down below. Then go to your Vita and into your Vita shell, connect to the PC, transfer VPK to your PS Vita, and then you simply install it by pressing X on it. Once you have it installed, that's all you need to do. The application is ready to go, but first you need to connect to the internet. And also don't forget to install ITLS Enzo application if you haven't already. I'm pretty sure it's necessary for this app to work correctly. This is it, the latest version of Netstream. Before we're gonna launch it, we're going to see the manual right in here. Here we're gonna check it, Netstream, here are all the controls. D-pad is for skipping as well as triggers. Cross is play pause, triangle show hide menu, circle close minimize. And start is for energy saving mode, that's for watching videos in the background. Here are what sources we can use. Netstream lets you watch YouTube videos and live streams on your PS Vita. You can read comments and live chat, add videos to favorites, download videos to your system. The built-in YouTube search supports multiple search filters for easier browsing. We can also play media content directly from HTTP or HTTPS server. And we can also play media content directly from an FTP server. And we can also play videos that are located on your internal storage. Here are all the supported formats for audio video and for audio. There are quite a lot of them. And here are all the player features. Netstream includes several convenient playback and power options to enhance your viewing experience. Accumulative rewind and fast forward. Energy saving mode, this is a really nice one. Press start button during playback to the energy saving mode. The screen will turn off, but the audio playback continues, allowing you to save battery power while listening. You can still adjust the volume. To exit, press the power or PS button. And the forbidden downloader is here as well, but we're not looking at that one. So let's launch the application. We are inside, so we can go into YouTube, HTTP server, FTP server or local storage. So we go into YouTube. And this is the home screen. There is nothing because we are not signed in. So there is no videos, no recommended videos. We can only search for videos right in here. Or we can go into the history, that's this button. It will show us what I was watching before, previously. Now I clicked on the star and here it's showing me videos that I put in favorites category. So let's for example click on this one of my latest videos, how to fix PS Vita crashing and freezing. Okay, so there is an error. The app is still work in progress, so you know, you may encounter some errors along the way, but it works. Let's try it again. It takes a bit time to load. I'm not sure if it's like my Wi-Fi connection, I'm connected to the hotspot, or if it's Vita, but it takes some time to load. Okay, let's launch this one. Loading and we are in. So here, as you can see, I press the star, so it's in my favorites category. Here we can go, you know, full screen. This is going back. This is play pause, cross. Triangle is showing the options, same as when I tap it. Now when I press star, you hear it's still playing, but you know, that's the power energy saving mode. Now I would like to go back into the playing video. Here it is. Let's try the fast forward. 5 seconds. So fast forward works. It also takes a while to... Ah, it's okay. It's not as long, you know, for it to load. Now I went like 30 seconds to the front. Yeah, it's okay. Here we can see also description of the video, but the comments as of right now are not really functional, at least for videos like this. On the live chat it should be supported, the comments I mean. So it looks like the comments are kind of working. I'm not gonna be clicking on it because I've seen in on the release page it might crash the system. So yeah, it at least showed some comments. I'll click it in a second. First let's check the settings. First option is search. As you can see, we can play with bunch of filters. Region, US, sort by relevance, date in, view count, date any. Then we go to comments, sort by top or new. We go to quality. In the quality, we can choose video quality, 480p, I think I'll go lower. And default live quality, I'll put also 360p. In the player, start minimized. And this is the build information about the application. As you can see, that's the latest version 3.32 from October 6th. Let's try to click on some comments. Looks like the comments are also working. That's great to know. Let's quickly check the GitHub release page. This version is experimental and may not operate correctly for some videos. NetStream no longer relies on InVideos for YouTube support. NetStream now uses modern YouTube Dash-like API for VOD videos, that's like video on demand, that's this kind of videos, not live stream, with extended audio and video quality list. There has been added cloud storage support for YouTube history and favorites. Cloud storage uses PlayStation Network server, so you must be logged into PlayStation Network in order to use it. I'm not, so I guess because of that it's not working. It is now possible to select the YouTube live streams in real time directly from the player page. Added more YouTube search filters. Drastically improved battery efficiency for video playback. Added SRT subtitle support. And here are some known bugs. YouTube videos, non-live stream comments are barely operational and may crash the application. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. YouTube's comments for now are hit or miss. And syncing on some YouTube videos may not be available. There was even a 3.32 release. Added proxy server support for YouTube. HTTP and SOX proxy servers are supported. And an issue was fixed with 720p resolution for some YouTube videos that resulted audio only playback. Okay, let's try the live stream. Not sure how we're gonna get to it. I'll just type live stream. Okay, now it works. Okay, looks like we are watching live YouTube video. Yeah, works okay. It took a bit of tries, but as you can see it works. Let's check settings. Okay, 360p, and let's check comments. Okay, error has occurred, so let's try it again. As I said, it's still in experimental phase, so yeah, the errors are gonna occur. Okay, we are watching another live stream. And we see all the comments, or at least, not sure if it's live chat or comments, I think it's comments. Okay, I think it's gonna crash again. So I guess it would be working, but I was just clicking on the comments, so yeah, I think you wanna avoid clicking on comments or live chat or anything like that. Okay, so final thoughts. I'm loving this application, it's great. So far the best update, in my opinion. Mostly because YouTube previously wasn't even working properly. Now it is. Main issues clearly are, at least for me, the loading, it takes a bit of time. I'm used to, you know, clicking and having everything ready, you know, in a second, but this is a bit different. And another issue are clearly the crashes, because there were quite a few of them. As I said, the application is still in experimental phase, but at least it's good to see, you know, there is some progress being made, which I'm a big fan of, and I'm sure you, all the comrades too. Installation is super easy. I think this application is surely must install for every modded PS Vita. I've tried even shorts and they were working. Here you can see shorts are working too, but clearly you need to know what you are looking for, the name, otherwise it's not gonna pop up. You need to search for it manually. As I said, beautiful update. I'm very excited. I know many of you were asking for a proper YouTube application for a while, cause you know, it's very useful. Now it's finally here, so I'm sure you're very happy. Don't forget to send a huge thanks to the developer Graphene. One more time, big shout out to him. You can just thank him in your mind and I'm sure he's gonna sense it, that you are grateful. Also, I just wanna mention that the Rayhan Vita Homebrew Contest is gonna be finished by the time I'm gonna release this video. Right now there are 59 total entries, which is a huge win in my opinion. I still have few of them left to install. I'll be making another video and then all of the judges are gonna have 7 days till the October 14th to come up with the winners. Stay tuned for that. If you enjoyed this video and it helped you, give it a thumbs up. Comment, like, subscribe, join, whatever your heart craves for. I would like to thank to all of my Patreons and channel members for their support. It's greatly appreciated. I would like to thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Peace. Just a regular everyday normal motherfucker. Told you in the first song and I tell you in another. Regular everyday normal motherfucker. Don't ever give in my hands, my only lover. Just a regular everyday normal motherfucker. One night a week my mom likes to cook me supper. Everyday normal motherfucker. Kitten was my favorite Batman. I was walking down the street just the other day. I saw these two fine bitches there walking my way. So what you girls doing? That's what I wanted to say. And suddenly I panicked, I started to shake. So I put my head down just to walk away. Had a catch you guys started to talk away. Did the heads down and then the press the bang. Cherry crowd to the touch and the down.